People suffering from depression are often prescribed pills by their psychiatrist. But you know what? They should just play LocoRoco instead, for the PSP. It's totally kiddish, and it's a silly game that does nothing but make you smile and make you feel really good about yourself. It's also one of the weirdest yet the happiest game ever made. You play this, and I guarantee you, you'll just have a smile on your face, and you'll just feel really happy. The graphics of the game resemble an art piece made by a 7-year-old kid, and the background music is ridiculous mumble jumble. It's odd, but for an odd reason, it just has that happy, optimistic vibe. It's a side-scrolling experience without violence, and surprisingly, it works. Controlling the movements and the tremblings of the earth itself with the shoulder buttons of the PSP, the goal of the game is to move these crazy ball creatures to the side while collecting berries. When the crazy creatures eat some berries, they grow fatter, and you can hit the circle button to make them split into multiple beings, or hold the circle button to make them into one fat blob of a thing again. Yeah, the game's pretty whack. That's really all there is to it. What's really cool are the environments and the unique little puzzles involved to get from here to there. There's a lot of different environments, there's a lot of colors involved in the game. It's a pretty short game. You can probably beat it in, I don't know, 6 hours, 5 hours. There's like 40 levels. Which are pretty short, but all the missions are just so really just fun. The music, while childish, does grow on you, and the gameplay, while extremely easy and casual, does have its charms. This game really would be perfect cure for people suffering from depression, at least for that time being. Once you beat it, there is really hardly any replay value, so I guess you have to stick to pills after that. But just for that 5 hours, it's a good cure, you know? I don't really know. You know, it's just a lack of replay value. It's just, once you get it, the novelty value is just really cool. The sequel, LocoRoco 2, feels more like an actual full-fledged game. This one just feels like more like an experiment. You know, you're just trying out new things, and you're just going from place to place. There is no, like, boss battles or penalties or what have you. Like, the sequel has boss battles. The sequel has game features. It actually feels like a game. LocoRoco 1, for the PlayStation Portable, it feels like a totally crazy, unique experience that, you know, it doesn't really feel like a game. It just feels like a really unique experience that just makes you smile, you know?